I don't like trap R&B, I like raw R&B. Bring back raw R&B. If Lo don't work with a great producer in the next year, 2 years, they're gonna fade out. Someone's gonna come and replace them. I'm so cold, so I'm gonna put on this blanket while I record this one. I hope you don't mind. So, I wanna talk to you guys about a singer that I came across the other day from my childhood. Her name's Yummy. But I was so obsessed with her voice, like I couldn't get over the tone of her voice. I couldn't get over what I was hearing. I hope that you remember her. If you don't, it's okay. 2000s, I was a singer, so you might have missed her. She released a song called Come Get It, featuring Jadakiss in 2006. That would be when Beyonce released her first album, Dangerous in Love, right? 2000 era, to me, like the sweet 2000 era where everyone was kind of trying to find their sound, and like the sound that was kind of breaking through was like this percussion. Everything was kind of heavy on the percussion, it's drums. Right, this percussion sound. What I noticed as a young aspiring singer, because I wanted to be a singer so bad when I was younger, I wanted a record deal so bad, right? I remember like all of a sudden this voice was coming at the radio, this sound was coming at this radio now, like, and it was a different. Like something as simple as me hearing your name. That kind of sound, I remember when I first heard Yummy, it was actually in Jaheim's song, Ghetto Fabulous, was it? I could hear Yummy's tone, her sound is so distinctive. You know what I mean? We don't hear those kind of tones of voice anymore. My mum used to play Jaheim's album on repeat all the time, and I actually could pick out her voice in the backing vocals. There was backing vocalists, and I said, there, that's that same girl again. A wild goose chase trying to find her again, figure out who was singing that part and where she was from. So, and I heard her again. Whenever you tell me just how you feel, holding on to a love someone real, didn't you know? The Rain released the song, didn't you know? I figured out she was from a group called The Rain. So The Rain were a group in 2006, right? And Yummy was a part of that group. I'm like, that's her again. She's here, she's at the forefront for now. So I've kind of been tracing her voice throughout my young, aspiring career. I don't really know why she wasn't able to establish herself though. Sometimes I think maybe her tone was like too unique. I also love that she sings in church as well and sings gospel. She sounds stunning singing gospel. It's really important. I just don't understand why she never made it, like, why she never bust. The girl's bad. So I don't understand, like, how is it like that you can have a great voice, a great song, and all these producers around you, and you still can't produce great music or consistently great music. Listen to her album. It was okay. It was okay. And that was another thing in the 2000s, actually. Like, the music was really suffering. Like, the albums weren't good. The quality of the album started to dip. The quality of the movies started to dip as well. The quality of everything started to just decline in the 2000s. Quite sad. I feel we haven't really got up since then, to be honest. When it comes to like rap and hip hop and R&B, I feel like we've been down since then. And the golden era is done, but actually, you know what? I'm not even gonna say that. The golden era is not done. Okay, it's coming back with a vengeance. That era was special, the golden era in 2000s or 2000s. So yeah, it was really annoying because I was like, I wanna get signed, I wanna get a record deal, but I don't have that tone. like, am I gonna get signed? I was like, I don't want to change my voice. Every now and then, there's always a shift in R&B. I don't hip hop, but in R&B, there's a tone of voice that becomes acceptable, and a style of voice that becomes acceptable, and what the old star gets pushed out, and the new star comes in. And I could hear it. And Little Mo was someone who's retaking. Like, she was getting rinsed on the pirate radio stations. DJ Denko, she was getting rinsed. Superwoman getting rinsed. Forever getting rinsed. I don't forget that voice, Little Mo. Ready to have some kids. Some kids ready for the life to live. I can't do that. It's not my voice. But it's like, she was so amazing. Then Nivea came out. I was like, oh my god, mom, I need her album. Album was Av. I couldn't believe how Av the album was. Where's the song? Like, these guys were releasing some hit singles, man. And the body of work was just crap. As an adult, I can actually appreciate it now. Like, I listen to the album, like, the album's good. But as a kid, when I put it in, I was like, where's the music? What's the rest of it? And they would put like no songs on the album, you know. I couldn't believe how many songs they put on the album. But the music just was not making it. And it just makes me think about like this quality and standard of music now, and like how we don't even have albums, and how we don't even have singers. Like, we have these like trap R&B singers. I don't like trap R&B. I like real R&B. Bring back real R&B. You understand? Like, I like real singers. I miss groups. I miss harmonies. I miss this. This is why I like flow. Like, I actually really enjoy flow because of their girl group with harmonies and bringing back a 2000 style of music. Like, it's not incredible, but it's a good start. You know, if they work with the right producer on the next album, they could take off. But if they don't, if Flo don't work with a great producer in the next year, 2 years, they're gonna fade out. Someone's gonna come and replace them. Flo is set a good foundation. Stella's voice is stunning. She's definitely one of my faves. And I wrote some songs for them actually. It's not my job to make you feel comfortable. I was gonna do short, quick videos on artists that I'm feeling, songs that I used to like, voices that I used to love growing up. But that Fantasia tone. Start to blush when somebody says your name. That American kind of southern pronunciation, the real thing. Yeah. So this video is gonna be short, but about the black voice and trends in tonality in music as well, in black music. Charge that to the game. I was like, who's that? As a young person, I was always into the voice. I would just, who's that? Charge that to the game. It's nice. I like that. It's a nice tone. My ear would just save it. We've got to bring back the singers. We've got to bring back the singers. We've got to bring back the groups and the harmonies and the singing from your spirit and just big voices and unique tones and this arrange of different type of singers from 2000. Not just ballad singers, big singers, but you know, the staccato, up-tempo singers as well. We need like a nice range of male and female groups. I want to be part of that movement, but I think Flo started it in the country anyway, and I'm going to continue it.